Welcome to a lesson on set builder notation. In this lesson, we will define set builder notation, represent a set using set builder notation, and then also compare set builder notation to other ways to represent sets of numbers. A collection of numbers can be described as a set. For example, this is a set containing the numbers 1, 3, 5, 9, and 13. These numbers are also often called elements. Set builder notation can be used to build or describe a set. This is especially helpful if the set has an infinite number of numbers or an infinite number of elements. So looking at an example, this is set builder notation. We read these as the set of all x's such that x is greater than or equal to negative 2. Notice in the second case, we've replaced a colon with a vertical bar. These are the two most common ways to represent set builder notation, and these two are equivalent. Let's take a look at a couple more examples before we try it ourselves. Here we have the set of numbers satisfying the formula 2x plus 1 such that x is an integer. This means x is an element of the set of integers. So if x is an integer and we substitute those values into the formula 2x plus 1, this would give us a set of odd integers. Next we have the set of all x's that are real numbers such that x equals x squared. So the only real values that satisfy x equals x squared would be when x is 0 and x is 1. So this set builder notation represents the set containing 0 and 1. And then finally we have the set of all x's such that x doesn't equal 0. This would be the set of all real numbers except 0. So in general, we use the following structure when using set builder notation. We start with the formula for the elements, and then a vertical bar or colon, followed by the restrictions. Now let's take a look at our own examples. We're asked to graph the given interval, then express using inequalities and set builder notation. So this is a nice review of interval notation, inequalities, set builder notation, as well as graphing an interval on the number line. So we'll begin by graphing this interval from negative infinity to 3, where the interval is closed on 3. Remember, the square bracket means 3 is included in the interval, so we'll have a closed point on positive 3. So if this is our number line, let's say this is 0 and this is 3. The interval includes positive 3, so we have a closed point here, and we'd have an arrow to the left approaching negative infinity. So now using an inequality, we can say that x is less than or equal to positive 3, and therefore using set builder notation, we can now say the set of all x's such that x is less than or equal to 3. So in many cases, you can just view set builder notation as a more formal way to represent an interval rather than just using an inequality. Let's take a look at another example. In this example, we want to graph the interval, then express using interval notation and set builder notation. Notice here our set is given using a compound inequality. So we'll begin by graphing this interval. Let's say this is 0 and this is negative 2 and this is 6. This is the interval where x is greater than negative 2 and less than or equal to 6. So this interval does not include negative 2, but it does include positive 6. So we'd have an open point on negative 2, a closed point on positive 6, and the interval between. So there's the graph of our interval. Now we want to express this using interval notation. So the interval starts at negative 2 and ends at positive 6, but it does not include negative 2, so we use a rounded parenthesis here. It does include 6, so we use a square bracket here. And then finally, for set builder notation, we would have the set of all x's such that x is greater than negative 2 and less than or equal to 6. We could also express this a slightly different way using two inequalities connected with and. For example, we could say the set of all x's such that x is greater than negative 2 and x is less than or equal to 6. These two would be equivalent using set builder notation. In this example, we're given the graph of an interval and asked to state the interval using interval notation, inequalities, and once again, set builder notation. Notice how we have an open point on negative 2, and then the graph moves to the right, approaching positive infinity. And therefore, using interval notation, we'd have the open interval from negative 2 to positive infinity. Notice how it's a rounded parenthesis here because it does not include negative 2, and we always have a rounded parenthesis for infinity and negative infinity. Next, for inequality, we would say that x is greater than negative 2, and therefore using set builder notation, we would have the set of all x's such that x is greater than negative 2. So what you'll recognize in many cases is that set builder notation is just more of a formal way to represent an interval than using just basic inequality notation. Let's take a look at one more example. This one we just want to give the set builder notation for the set of numbers listed here. We have the set of even numbers. All even numbers are multiples of 2, and therefore using set builder notation we can say that all even numbers would be the set satisfying the formula 2 times x such that x would be an integer, which we can say x is an element of the set of integers, which we can represent using a capital Z. Of course, we could also spell this out and say x is an integer. I hope you found this lesson helpful.